This video, we're going to work with one theorem about functions in product spaces. This theorem will show us why it is often more desirable to work with product topology and not with a box topology. Because if you think about it, the box topology is way simpler, right? I mean, the definition is just doing the products of open elements for each space. However, for the other topology, for the product, you have to be careful that in this product, only a finite amount of these elements are not the whole space. So why is it that we actually prefer working with the product and not the box? Because anytime you hear the product space, it will always be working with the product topology. So why is this? From your multivariate calculus course, you probably know that if we have, let's say, a function f that goes from the real numbers onto, let's say, R3, just to keep things simple, let's say that f is defined as 2x plus 1, 3x minus 2, and x squared, then you know that this function is continuous. And to see that it's continuous, using the definition of continuity is actually very complicated. But what we do in multivariate calculus is we say, okay, let's call these functions f1, f2, and f3. And we have a theorem that says that f is continuous if and only if f1, f2, and f3 are all the three of them continuous. So when you look at these functions, each of these is obviously continuous, and so this implies that our function f is continuous. Well, now we want to have something similar for product spaces, because here R3 would be similar to this product of just any set. Well, let's look at the following theorem. Let's say we have a function that goes from some set A, it doesn't matter what it is, to the product space. And this function just takes one element, and like this one, each coordinate will be given by some function f alpha from a to x alpha. So it will be the same, because here f1 was a function from the real number to the real numbers, and the same for f2 and f3. Each of these functions is the coordinate function. Here we will call it f alpha, and it goes from a to x alpha. And we give our space, our product space, the product topology. So what happens is, what we have here, f is continuous, if and only if each of the coordinate function is continuous. Let's first work on the proof for this theorem, and then let's see why is it not saying box topology. So the theorem says if and only if. That implies that we have to prove both directions. So let's start with this one. This one is almost trivial. We have that f is continuous, and we want to prove that each coordinate is also continuous. But now f alpha is the projection in the alpha coordinate composition or function. Now this one we know is continuous. Let's see why the projection is always continuous. Well, for this, we should take pi alpha, the preimage of some open set u alpha. But this is an element in the subbasis. Remember that the product topology was defined via a subbasis of elements of this type. So, trivially, it's open. And so, pi alpha is continuous. And the composition, because of what we know about composition of functions, is also continuous. Now let's see the other direction. We have that f alpha is continuous, and we want to prove that our function is also continuous. To prove that this function f is continuous, we should take an open set in the product topology and prove that the preimage through f is also open. So to do this, it's enough to show it for an open set in the basis or in the subbasis. So what I'm going to do is, well, take the preimage of some open set This is obviously an open set in the product. And now, for this element, take the pre-image of F. This element is an open set in the product topology, and so I'm taking just the pre-image of an open set. But this is actually pi beta composed with F, the pre-image of U beta. And pi beta composed with F is actually F beta. And now, because F alpha is continuous for all alpha, this has to be an open set. And so the function F is continuous. Now let's see, why is it that this theorem is not saying the box topology instead of product? And we will see that this fails in a particular case. So we will call R omega to the product for all n natural number of the real numbers. So it's just a countable product of the real numbers. It's not Rn, it's greater, it's omega, so it's countable. And we will define a function that goes from the real numbers to this set R omega, so to the countable product of the real numbers, defined as f of t, the constant function. So on each coordinate, it's going to have the same value. This function in the product topology, the identity function from the real numbers onto the real numbers with the standard topology, is continuous, and so f is continuous. And what about the box topology? Well, we will prove that f is not continuous. And so for this, I have to take an open set and prove that the pre-image of that open set through F is not open. So I can take B minus 1, 1 times minus 1 half, 1 half, and so on, minus 1 over N, 1 over N. And this is a countable product, so it will just continue, and we will see that the pre-image of P through F is not an open set. Well, what happened if it was? Then there would exist some number delta greater than zero, such that the interval minus delta delta was a subset of the pre-image of P. This is simply because zero is an element here. Because zero is an element in each of these open sets, then obviously f of zero is zero, and so it's in this pre-image. So there must be a neighborhood of zero that's a subset of this set. This is if the set was open. But what happens is that there exists some natural number n such that 1 over n is smaller than delta. And here we're taking the infinite product of open sets, minus 1 over n, 1 over n. So what happens is that when we reach this number n, then delta will not be a subset of the minus 1 over n, 1 over n, thus proving that this intersection cannot happen. So what we would write is fn of minus delta delta is obviously the identity, so it's going to be minus delta delta, but minus delta delta is not a subset of minus 1 over n, 1 over n, because 1 over n is smaller than delta. So this is a contradiction. And then we know that this set cannot be open, and we have that in the box topology, this function f, the identity function, is not continuous, even if each of its components is continuous. So it doesn't satisfy this theorem, and this is the reason why we usually work with the product topology instead of the box topology. We will continue working with more examples of continuous or non-continuous functions in the exercises, so stay tuned for more videos like this. If you want to support the channel, you can do so by making a small donation on Ko-fi. You can also become a member on Patreon to get exclusive content and merch, or you can buy a t-shirt with our t-shirt store. See you in the next one.